Greetings and welcome back, housemate. This is Skyrim. We're holed up at the Bannered Mare. We just slept 12 hours, and fortunately our leg trauma looks like it's going to heal sometime today. And I set up my hotkeys. What I found out about the hotkeys, and I'll talk about hotkeys a lot till I get it right, is it's best to have armor hotkeys and weapon hotkeys, and keep them separate. Also, double tap and single tap hotkeys cannot be on the same button. You can also do shift 1 and shift 2 and control and alt, but I'm going to stick with press and press and hold for the moment. I like press and hold on my longbow because the longbow takes preparation, so you should know. Sorry, dog. Oh, yeah. So you should know what's up with it. What I mean is, you should have plenty of time to hold down the button because you're using a long-range weapon with a lot of pull time. And if you don't, then don't use it. The single press
I'm
will be sufficient.
I heard it howling. Those werewolves.
Fall from glory. I guess I've read that one as well. Good job, Doug. And by good job, I mean get out of my way. That striking sound is actually me falling on people. You, with the Vigor mod installed, you can ram at people.
You have committed crimes against Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense? Smart woman. Now, come along with us.
Okay. What happened? Perhaps it was from falling on the dog? Well, this may be the best possible time to mention this, but I did clear out that bandit refuge and veterans retreat, so I'd appreciate if you guys let me off easy. And I haven't collected the reward yet, so could you take my fines out of the reward money? Thanks. I appreciate it. You there.
Keep your distance.
Oh, that seems quite rude. And I haven't heard the word housecarl ever before in my life, so.
Come to Dragon's Reach to discuss the ongoing hostilities, like the rest of the great warriors.
Can I use this?
Don't get too far ahead.
Necklace of fire is this, huh? I can deconstruct it some other time, but it's good to know. So you're an alchemist as well, and what does this do? Okay. I can make staves here, huh? I don't feel comfortable using this guy's alchemy lab. Ah, Jarl.
Valgrunt, my Jarl. A word, if I may.
Speak.
One of the servants had a wonderful idea. Fireproofing Dragon's Reach, in case of attack by air.
Yes, yes, take care of it, Prometheus. Whatever it is you're talking about.
As you say, my Jarl.
I
serve Jarl Balgrunt as steward. Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward.
Thank you, and I'm sorry about all that other stuff.
To the tavern will make you an easy target for an enemy assassin. You should have told me first.
Enjoy your visit to Dragon's Reach.
I will.
Apologize for talking to my.
Jarl seems a little busy. And she sounds pissed. So let's get out of here. Ah, I have it. We will clean out the undead at the Temple of Kinnereth. Akarith? The gods. Let's get all suited up.
To rule the realm.
little bit of prayer. Oh, I should do some alchemy. But the
It's a shame, isn't it?
The crypts can't be that large.
I ain't done nothing.
Still, best be prepared. Maybe there's something to do with maybe I can find a potion that it helps me against the undead.
Do you have anything even remote?
Got something for just about everybody in. Give a holler if you have any questions.
Did we sample all our ingredients? I doubt we did. Oh, that's right. We were dying of ingredients. Consumable is not recognized by INE. Do you want it to be? No. What did that do? Discerning. What is that? You'll discern an effect of the first ingredient you consume. Oh, interesting. I can eat doe antlers to better identify other items. Ugh. Oh, I see, it works only once.
I sell cures for all it.
Oh, intriguing. Intriguing.
And I'll be happy.
Discern Hunter's Boon.
To serve you.
We'll have to hunt more doe. That is an impressive power. Pathfinding. What does pathfinding do? Sense the path towards your goal very briefly. Interesting. Must be Night Eye. So the discerning ability I'm going to use for the items that I don't have many of. Oh, fatigue is bad. There goes all my stamina. Am I dead? Did I die? I think I discerned that paralyzes me. I collapsed after eating a whole mammoth heart. Well, that probably makes sense. It's probably about Game of Thrones level of disturbing to watch, too.
You'll find tonics, Sap.
Eye of the Fox.
There's poultices and potions on my shelves.
Let's try this on the more interesting things. We only have like one of.
To your heart's content.
Okay, fortunately none of these are killing us. And maybe that's all the discerning we have. Damage undead. Mourning cloaks. Okay. Whew. Fortunately, the fear from Namira's rot did not affect us. No, my intelligence. Okay, the poisonous effects of some of these are actually threatening to your health with all the mods I have installed. Water walking. Like, Ravage Health could be bad. The way Ravage Health works is after a period of time you take a rather severe amount of damage. Is there anything that's like resist poison? Apparently not. Okay, after all that disgustingness, must have already eaten my treats. Oh well.
If there's anything I can help you with, you have but to ask.
Only 4 points of health. Let's make it. Let's experiment.
I offer remedies for ailments both common and rare. Do let me... if I can be of service.
So I want to try only potions that have unknown effects.
If there's anything I can help you with, you have but to ask.
To find out as many effects as possible with the ingredients I have. Luna Moth and Namira's Rot have health regeneration. Curious.
You find tonics, salves, poultices, and potions on shelves. Browse to your heart's content. If there's anything I can help you with, you have but to ask.
Alright, Blue Mountain Flower has damaged health. That means none of our remaining ingredients actually have damaged health besides canine teeth. I want to make a batch of strong poisons. So I don't want to waste those. Nor do I want to waste these fatigue poisons I could be making. So let's simply go ahead and make these. We'll try adding in some other stuff just to see if there's some sort of additional effect.
I offer remedies for ailments both common and rare. Do let me know if I can be of service.
No such luck. Okay.
If there's anything I can help you with, then I've got to ask. I sell cures for all ills, and I'll be happy to serve you.
Oh my. So wolf claws and purple mountain flowers can damage undead. That is exactly what we're looking for. It also increases the undead's archery skill by 10 points for a minute, which we could avoid. Or we can't, but we're definitely making two of those since we're about to go down into a crypt.
You'll find tonic.
It's worth it to throw in other crazy ingredients. You only want two. Okay, health fortification. What? Restore health, damage magicka. An awkward potion, to be sure.
Potions on my shelves. Browse to your heart's content.
Damage, damage, okay. Okay, now we have a good hold on what these particular items do.
I sell cures for all ills.
This night vision is blinding me. I feel like I got flashbanged. Also, Eric? Where? Okay, I was like, Eric. You doofus, where are you?
Pardon me. So you're interested in my potions and ingredients?
Well, I will trade you my screwed up potions for more ingredients. How about that? I do want to keep all my poisons and healing. Fire aversion on its own is nothing I'm interested in. Fortify speech. Maybe I should have that right now.
Come back anytime. Need a remedy. I have several elixirs for sale.
I mean...
So you're interested in my potions and ingredients?
Mm-hmm. Of course I am. See, the potion of speech is working already. I would love to talk to you about the things you like. Regenerate 4% faster for 300 seconds. That doesn't seem so bad. At least keep me alive. Oh, it's a poison. Sell it then. I don't feel like giving my enemies health regeneration. That's too weak to be of any use. Okay, those are notably great poisons against undead. Very interested in applying some of that. These poisons of mine are quite effective. Since you like that one so much. Four points of health. Yeah, so I should keep those with me. I'm sure I'll need them at some point. Okay, now it's time to try these things you have. I will take your cheapest ingredients. Ugh, the price of knowledge. Regeneration, though. It's always good to have more salt. Seen such a thing. Just a taste.
Yeah. If there's anything I can help you with, you have but to ask.
Red mountain flowers restore health. Oh. It'll hurt my magicka, but...
I sell cures for all ills, and I'll be happy to serve you.
We're just going to have to create a boatload of these, because this is as good a magical healing as I'm going to get. Odds, though, that fire is bright.
I offer rem.
Is there anything else I wanted to sell? These things are heavy as hell. Favorited so that I can
for ailments both common and rare. Do let me know if
you can access them at will. Ugh. Alright, Eric, I'm gonna go sleep off. This migraine that I seem to have gotten from eating all sorts of random ingredients. I hope it's gone when I wake up.
Hero named Ragnar the Red who came riding to Whiterun.
It won't go away. If you get stuck somewhere with weird effects, it might be worth trying to reload. But apparently, that's not my issue. And then...
But...
Let's put this on.
He went quiet, did Red. The Red, when he met the maiden Matilda, was...
Okay. Or check the things that cause that, equip it, unequip it. Okay, we've gained a bit of skill as an alchemist, and we've winnowed out our inventory of crazy ingredients at no small price to our vision. But We now have a couple of potions of lingering damage to undead.
It's a fine day with you around.
We have made a friend there. And I believe it is time to clear out.
You tried mercenary work? It might suit you.
Sometimes I miss the soldier's life.
Mercenary work?
But when I hold my daughter in my arms, I know I made the right choice.
My Sapphire doesn't like that I've been spending so much time looking for my father's old sword. He fed his entire family with the gold he made using that weapon. I'm not about to let it gather dust in some thief's trophy room.
Well, you do have a child. Would you be interested in handing off that task?
I tracked it to a group of bandits nearby. But I'm no fool.
Perhaps?
I'd need the Whiterun guards or maybe hire the companions to get it.
Perfect.
I don't know why I'm saying this, but if you find it out in your travels, I'd be grateful to you.
Of course. White River Watch.
If you find that sword, please bring it to me.
Very well.
Do you get to the Cloud District very often?
So much time with this terrible war, I'm a bit overwhelmed, as are the catacombs.
Okay, keep a low profile, Eric. We don't want to wake more of the undead than we have to. Belay that order, Eric. Kill everything that moves. Holy, Eric, behind you. Ow, my face. Oh, that hurt. Let's try out some of these potions since I have so frickin' many. Increase health by 2, restore 0 points of health, decreases my magic recharge. Do they all restore 0 points of health? Oh, what a fool I am. Should go sell these damn things. All they do is swallow my magicka. Skeletons can put themselves back together, huh? Well, that sure is unpleasant. Okay. Face forward. I should just go sell these when I get the chance. Let's have this draught of healing, I guess. Oh, I should have saved that. Whatever. You get nervous when you start dying. And when skeletons get back up from the dead. What is this? Unusual gem. Just what I always wanted. Yes, we should get this appraised sometime, Eric. Never seen something quite like it, nor heard of it. Well, this coin person silver goblet. Obvious, RK wouldn't miss with just one. Death blow of a baronet. Interesting. Let's take this with us. It's giving me some ideas about how to get my shield in the way faster. I want to get better at alchemy. And I think it's time to learn to safeguard my life better with a little bit of blocking skill. Eric.
Hey, watch it!
You're in my way.
What's the hurry?
The hurry is undead. The hurry is undead, Eric. That is what the hurry is. Living, moving skeletons. I know we're scavenging the crypt a little bit, but it's just a little bit of scavenging. Did we make it? Is it done? I only took one silver goblet. RK can keep the rest. Well, it does seem like we've done what we can. Ah, there we are. That was what they needed. Oh, that skeleton hit me pretty hard there. Now, let's take a look at these things. Well, wherever they got these swords and shields, no one would blame me if I melted them down and turned them into something useful. Probably cursed anyway. I bet I can convince everyone that they need to be destroyed, lest they be the cause of the undead rising again. So, let's get out of here.
Nice.
You didn't tell me that the undead can get back up after being re-deadified.
Oh, thank RK!
I suppose it makes more
Please,
sense than I was thinking.
Take this gold for your troubles.
15 gold.
Of course.
May the blessing of RK be upon you.
Cheap churches. What is the blessing of RK? I would sample this blessing that you speak of. Twenty-five extra points of health. I will take that over whatever Talos's blessing is. Okay, that turned out well enough. Time to visit the forge, I believe.
Of course you don't.
Snob.
Ulfred. Patron of the great clan Battleborn.
Fool.
Come to chat with an old woman?
Nope. I've not come to chat with an old woman. Thanks for asking. More inside. No wonder everyone hates adventurers. We're jerks. Ancient Nord, huh? So I can smelt it down. Or I could try and learn ancient Nordic smithing techniques. Sell the circlet. Let's smelt it down into iron. I'm pretty sure I can make more useful things. Note that one of my mods prevents me from destroying anything that I favorited or am currently have equipped, which is nice. Thus, my shield and weapon don't appear on the smelt down into ore list. Now, what would be interesting to make? For one, I should most likely...
I don't claim to be the best blacksmith in Whiterun.
sharpen up my boots. Man and any equipment I can with iron.
All I ask is a fair chance.
It just feels right somehow.
Eric, aren't you carrying some stuff?
No problem. How can I help?
Yes, give me this. We'll be... Mammoth Tusk. I don't know that... Well, we'll see if I can do anything with that. Forgotten about those.
Let's get going then.
Let's do get going. I should get you a backpack so you can carry more of this load for me. Now, what have we here? I suppose I can't make anything too impressive. Don't have any silver. Make a lantern. Dark leather and leather strips, huh? Break anything down into iron ore? No. All right, well, let's just get to practicing. Show me that sword of yours again. And I think I can make an iron one of those. I should make some more iron arrows, I suppose.
Got some good pieces out. Can buy more inside.
Fruits and vegetables is a noble purpose, child.
Don't get too far ahead.
What do you give me for these?
I don't claim to be the best. Looking to protect yourself or deal some damage?
I know. They're not much. Switch completely over to iron arrows now, which is nice. You're at the forge all day, Adrian?
Plenty. I'd say we're prosperous enough. Most folk don't. The city's... But you're probably more interested in your Vasker, Mead Hall of the Companions. Their deeds of war and valor are legendary. Have you met my father? He's a steward up at Dragon's Reach.
I have.
Until next time.
Mead Hall of the Companions, huh? Must be up in the Cloud District.
You tried mercenary? Might suit you.
They say the college has been snooping around Sarkar. Mages and veterans.
All I can think about is my son, my Thorold. They say that he was killed, but I know better. I know my son is alive.
What do you sell
Those
here?
Those battle-born. They're in with the Imperials. They know it too. And yet they lie to my very face.
How do you know they're lying?
It's not wise to discuss it here. Please, if you truly wish to help, meet me at my home. I'll tell you the whole story.
There's a rift here in Skyrim. Can't neither magic nor the passing of time make it right.
Very well.
Evgir, I have come at last. The season.
Let me wrap up my business
Life's
here.
Life's hard enough with all these men propositioning me, but that bard Mikhail is begging for a dagger up against his throat, the way he goes on about me.
Give it to him.
I heard him boasting at the Bannered Mare, saying he'll conquer me as a true Nord conquers any harsh beast.
Pardon.
If you want to try, go right ahead. I don't think anything will get through that thick skull of his, though.
Interesting. Well, I've drunk enough with Mikhail to know what kind of man he is. Oops. I couldn't resist. The other smith we've heard so much about.
Got a lot of steel to shape. The Skyforge? My clan fathers have worked it since the first Grey Mains came to Whiterun. Skyforge steel is all the companions will use, for good reason.
Tell me about yourself.
Are you blind, Gerg? I'm a blacksmith. Any halfwit could see that.
Friendly, too.
Gods be praised.
Dwarven arrows, huh? A step up from iron, to be sure. Eek, the prices on this. Thresher Maul. Wolf sword, huh? I might be interested in those dwarven arrows. Skyforge steel shield. I could use a shield. This shield is incredible. Don't whine about it, Eric. It's for everyone's good. Steel gauntlets? Yes. Okay, well, I don't need the arrows if I have these. I should sell my iron. I'll go break it down at the forge. But I should definitely set up. Nope, not those. Iron boots and steel, everything else. So that was my heavy armor hotkey. Generally, I want to wear this stuff. I should have that favorite as well. Quite a shield. Quite a shield.
We are the children of man. Talos is the true god.
Who's that?
To rule the realm.
I spend a lot of time at the market stalls. Once I've made enough money trading with the Khajiit caravans,
yes, of course,
I'm
of
going
course.
To buy the bannered mare.
I believe this is Frelia's house.
Welcome to our home.
Mother, what's the meaning of this?
Oh,
who have you brought into our home?
Put it away.
Put that down.
Please.
She's here to help us find Thorald.
All right.
How do we know she's not spying for the Battleborn? This was foolish.
I'm rethinking
my... We can't trust anyone. Who knows what they'll do if they find me here?
I can't take any more of this. No weapons, please. Let's just talk.
All right.
Very well.
So, you're here to help?
What can I do for you?
What can I do?
I know that Thorald's not dead. I just know it. The Imperials have him and are keeping him somewhere. But I don't know where. Those damned Battleborns. They know something. They're hiding it. They practically taunt us with it. They must have some sort of proof. There's gotta be something in that house of theirs. I just know it. I don't dare leave the house myself, so I need your help.
Anything
that confirms that Thorald isn't dead, but is being held captive. I know those Battleborns have it. They'd be hiding it, of course. Wouldn't want it to get out that they've been lying this whole time. But you might be able to butter them up enough to lower their guard.
Very well.
Best if you didn't mention to anyone that you saw me here.
That makes sense.
Please, anything you can do to help me find my Thorald.
Very well. We'll do what we can. We'll come back to this when our speech is better. Now, White River Watch. Yes, I think that's where we'll go next. We'll strike at night, since we're well rested. This is not the right way to go.
Damn those Grey Maids to oblivion. They want to back the storm cloaks.
I heard the gourmets hiding out somewhere in Skyrim. You know, fella who wrote that cookbook?
Oh, I saw that in Bellathor's
shop. The temple
here
in the city is my charge. The goddess's divine blessings have no doubt helped make Whiterun a thriving and prosperous city. After all, it is she who brings rain to our crops and fair weather on the harvest days. Grace of Kinnereth be with you.
A pleasant enough god. I should construct a nice suit of leather armor for both of us, I think. You really just don't look comfortable in that heavy armor, Eric. Oh, Eric. I'm shaking my head. You can't see me, but I'm shaking my head, Eric. I have to go looking for that treasure some other time. Soon, though. Are those Moras? This will fetch a tidy sum, although it might be worth knowing what you can make with him. Now that I'm a little more alchemically savvy, let's say. Did you hear something? I thought I did. We need to catch more of these bugs. Remember catching water in the springs back around Rorikstead? Right? Those were the days when I wasn't being hunted by assassins. The good old days. Tundra cotton is actually worth quite a bit, strangely enough. It's pretty much everywhere. Now, I believe somewhere up there is Whitewatch, I believe. Eric. Let's get armored. Get a clear shot up there. Let's get this done and out of the road. Friend or foe, do you think, Eric? Seems friendly enough.
I am. If you are not here to grant me a good death, then you can leave.
Good death?
Yes. Were I to simply lay down and die, it would not please Malakath. My time has come. I am old. Too old to become chief. It would be wrong for me to take wives at this age, so I will die. Malakath has given me a vision of a glorious death. I am to wait here until it finds me. As you can see, it has not yet arrived.
Uh-huh.
Indeed. One should find his death while he can still call himself a proper man. We Orkmen are not like these Nords and Imperials who carry on until they are gray and feeble and their hair falls out. To cling to something past its usefulness is unseemly. How much more so when that thing is you?
It seems there's no talking you out of
this. You should leave. I don't want you scaring off my good death.
If you are
not here to grant me a good death, then you can leave.
Under the two moons? Very well, Orc.
Perhaps. Are you sure about this?
I am sure.
We shall see.
Perhaps not me. He is rocking us. So he annihilated us.
I'll show you a real.
So we're gonna leave that orc alone now. And he can keep his death. We will, however, try this sweet shot from out here. Well, my friends, that orc was more than a match for us. Even all three of us together. Or at least me. Maybe Eric could have taken him. But I foolishly thought I could. And I'm pretty sure his good death didn't involve us ganging up on him and poisoning him, so. Like I said before, when I'm killed, I'll give up on the task I was currently involved in. Which in this case was dealing with that orc. Now there is a horse without a master over there. But let's move on. Or let's actually, okay, let's investigate that. And wrap up this episode. And then the next episode will be taking out the bandits. Capturing the old sword from White Watch. A bandit Doom Rager. Let's gather up his equipment. It's quite heavy. Give that steel shield to Eric.
It just feels right somehow. No problem. How can I help?
No.
Lead on.
A horse. Ah, I need to install some mods for horses. This will be very useful with fast travel disabled. For now, we will leave him here. Perhaps this is the horse we can ride once. A man cannot truly claim a horse that is not his own. Perhaps we can get the first shot off. Although if we have to switch back into our heavy armor, it will be a disgrace. Do switch into our heavy armor.
Thought I heard something. Is that the best you can do?
Eric.
Just give up.
I'm too exhausted to run in.
This is the part. Fall down and flee to death.
This is the end for you.
I'll have your head.
I'm afraid it's the end for you, my dear. Stamina is so important, so hard to come by. Steel claw? Okay. It's cheap and easy to carry. A brown bear cloak of resist magic? Oh yes. And a dwarven maul. Salute to Rodolph. Steel arrows. Dwarven Maul. It's as good as our steel war pick, but not quite my style. Still.
It just feels right somehow.
Eric, you're more skilled with one-handed weapons. An adventurer.
No problem. How can I help?
What do you think about this dwarven maul?
Lead on.
Not your thing. Well, you can hold on to that for a while. Before we go in here, in the episode, and we'll be back. Alright guys, this has been another episode of Let's Play Skyrim. I'm Phwop, this is Margaret, Eric, unnamed dog. And remember that we'll see you next time, and it's all downhill from here.